Hey, my friends, how are we doing? So I did a thing. Before that, it just got done raining, so it's really loud when the cars go by. We are under a tornado warning. We did just have a downspout in the lake. And then, on top of that, I realized it's bike week. They rescheduled bike week for this week. And here in New Hampshire, every time it's bike week, it always rains. So you're gonna hear lots of bikes. So I uploaded these videos and they're not going up. I don't know why. So I gotta redo them without doing the unboxing. I bought a secondhand Be Happy Speckled Fawns. It's a rustic Kodiak with the Berry Berry Kodiak and a Dublin pocket. I altered it yesterday. This piece, a leather, was right there. So this is what it looked like when it came to me. It was a very straight pocket. I looked down inside and saw that. So I altered it. I took a pair of scissors and just went, pulled it off. And I burnt the edges with a lighter to make it look aged. And afraid, I took the scissors and I scraped along the edge. Now my scissors are dull. So I bought this hoping that the one I've been using, which is just my rustic Kodiak with a Black Beauty wrap, it's got a little branding on it. I bought it in hopes of putting it in this one so I could use this one for something else. So take my pens off. This is exactly the same size, but I don't think it's gonna fit the same. Oh, I had this book tucked in this pocket. I got the entire Jibun Techo system tucked in the back corner, and the it's called the diary, which is the planner part, is tucked into the cover, and this is tucked into the cover as well, and this is tucked into the cover, which is all tucked into the back. I'm gonna try putting it on the strings because I thought maybe that would help it lay a little bit flatter. Not that that doesn't lay flat, but it's pretty hefty with that plastic sleeve and everything in it. I'm gonna stick this guy under two bands because it's pretty wide. How's everybody doing? I'm doing good. It just poured like there's no tomorrow. And we didn't really get any wind right here, and the lake is literally right there, like 1,000 feet down that road across the way from me. But there was a downspout, which is basically a tornado, but it's on water. It hits the water and sucks the water up and makes quite a little swirly. Really neat to work at, look at. It's kind of scary, but ooh, kind of scary that it was right there. So, oh, look at that right off the bat. That's not good. Let me hold on. Look at that. It's sticking out from the side a little bit, which it doesn't do in that one. But it looks nice. Smells fantastic. I love speckled fawns. The owner is Terry Haskell. She's a one-woman show right now due to COVID. She had to let all her people go. And she's still catching up on orders from before because she's doing all the individual steps herself, which is crazy to think about. It's like when you first start out doing leather notebooks and you got no help. Okay, so that's what this looked like. This normally slips in this back pocket, so you can use this to hold it. It is very, very tight. You can see that it's hanging over. in this one. And this has got a 1-inch reinforced spine, but yet in this one, there is no hangover. It comes, the leather actually protects all of it. So when you put the band on, you're not touching your inserts and the pen boot sticks out. I don't know about that other one. Let me see. Tuck this back in there. Stick that pen loop out. Oh, yeah, it doesn't want to do it. I'm sure it can be trained. Let's see. See that? It's still... I don't... Maybe in time. But this is what... What concerns me. It, not doing it on the back because I got it flush in the back. But it's also kicking the spine sideways. And if you straighten the spine out, the whole whop of crap pokes up. But that's okay. It's got strings, so that's a plus from this one. This one is just a folio. I chose no strings for this. So I wanted to put my Wonderland 222 in it. Because I don't have a cover for this, and I figured it would fit pretty good in here. Slide it in that back pocket. Close her up. Oh, tight. It does stick out. Oh, what a bummer. What a bummer. But that's okay, because the backside for me is completely covered. It won't, I don't think it will do it in that one. Let me look while we're right here, right? Get that so I don't bang and clang. I love the Kodiak. It's so beautiful. Oh, I wanted to show you the texture difference. They're the same leather. It's just one's got more texture. See how lumpy and bumpy that is? Yeah, this is Kodiak as well. And that's still not as pebbled. This is pretty smooth. That cool? Those three right here. 1, 2, 3, 4 are all Kodiaks. So I don't know why. I guess I can't upload a video that's over 30 minutes. Oh, I just did it in that one, fool. Oh, my shoulder. Can we tuck it in? Yes, it definitely fits in the back. Come some bikes. It's not allowing it to bend over and cover. That's a major difference in the two. Holy shit. Oh, shoot. So let's see if I can place it in the center. It's gonna... If I put it on the strings, it's definitely gonna stick out. Isn't that crazy that the same exact size? The only difference is one has a reinforced spine, one doesn't. You see that? And they're both the same size. I'm not kidding you. I will lay them one on top of the other. Do you see? Even there, even there. Isn't that weird? I really love the red stitching. I was going to take my... bookmark off of this one and put it onto this one because of the red stitching. I thought it would just like pop. And that's a phoenix, by the way. So look what I did. I done altered it and it done fit for what I want it to work for. Freaking fruitcake. So now I got a piece of leather. This smells awesome. I will turn this into a bookmark because why not, right? Alrighty. Thanks for popping in and watching this one. So weird. The same exact situation, except for the 1-inch reinforced spine is making it very difficult for books too, working it. Maybe I'll take that spine out. And then I'd have a strip of leather to do what I want with. We'll see what I do. I don't know. Alrighty guys, thanks for popping by. Please stay safe, stay healthy, keep being creative. Share some smiles. We all need them in this time. I love you. I will catch you in the next one. Like it if you wouldn't mind. Subscribe even better because I do love doing giveaways and I want to do some more. Okay? Hit the bell. I'll bug you.